Good morning, children. Today we are going to start a new lesson in English literature. Okay, so we are going to start Wandering Singers. This is a poem by Sarojini Nandu. Wandering Singers, this poem reflects the art of our country. Okay, you see here, this is a poem about traveling singers who are going throughout our country, throughout India they are going, and who sing about ancient cities. The ancient, what is the meaning of ancient? Means very old cities. Okay, they are telling about, they are singing actually about our ancient cities, lost kingdoms, brave soldiers and beautiful queens. So I shall explain you this poem, but let us first know about the poetess, because she is a lady, so we are talking about poetess. Okay, she is Sarojini Naidu. She was born in 1879 and she died in the year 1949. She was a poet and played an important role in India's struggle for freedom. See, now you see, nowadays the poetess and the poet, both, whether the she is the poetess, she is the lady, or he is a poet, okay, he is a man, we can refer as poet only. But here, for your knowledge, I have written here just poetess. So Sarojini Naidu was a poet and played an important role in India's struggle for freedom. In our struggle for independence, she played a very important role. Her poems are known for the simple themes and melodious words. Melodious words are there, very sweet and pleasant words are there in her poem, and very simple themes. They speak about the lives of common people. The common people, the, you can say our the people in the villages, they are the most common people, right? Some of her famous poems include Palanquin Bearers, The Bangle Sellers in the Bazaars of Hyderabad, and The Coromandel Fishers. These are her famous poems, okay? So now let us come to the poem itself, Wandering Singers. Wandering, what is the meaning of wandering? Wandering means going here and there, roaming about. Okay, roaming around, you can say. This is the meaning of wandering. Now, first of all, you should read the poem properly. Let us first start reading. Where the voice of the wind calls our wandering feet, through echoing forest and echoing street, with lutes in our hands, ever singing we roam. Please see, children, these singers, they have lute in their hands. You see, you open this, you can say this is page number 41. Okay, you open this page 41 and you see the singers, they have lutes in their hands. That is a musical instrument, old musical instrument that looks like guitars, but actually they are not guitars, but looks like that. And the sounds are also some similar. All men are our kindred, the world is our home. Our lays are of cities whose luster is shed, the laughter and beauty of women long dead. The sword of old battles, the crown of old kings, and happy and simple and sorrowful things. What hope shall we gather? What dreams shall we sow? Where the wind calls our wandering footsteps, we go. No love bids us tarry, no joy bids us wait. The voice of the wind is the voice of our fate. This is a very beautiful poem and it has a very deep meaning, children. I shall explain you. Today I am going to explain you a little. Again in my next class, I shall explain you. Now you see here, the poem Wandering Singers by Sarojini Naidu is about the band of folk singers who wander from town to town. Band of folk singers means they sing folk songs, the old traditional songs, okay, you can say of the kings and queens. Now you see, they wander, they roam from town to town, you can say from village to village also, spread the message of love and affection through their singing. Okay, they play the lute. Just now I told you it is a musical instrument. They play the lute, a musical instrument, as they roam from place to place. Now you see the voice of the wind indicates the welcoming tone of the song. The voice of the wind here, we are talking where the voice of the wind calls our wandering feet. The voice of the wind indicates the welcoming tone of the song. Okay children, now this first two lines you see where the voice of the wind calls our wandering feet, where they are going, where the wind is calling them. They are going there, they are roaming through echoing forest and echoing street. Echoing their, through their songs, what they are singing. The forest is echoing, the streets are echoing, because they are roaming from here to there. They don't belong to a particular place. They keep on roaming. And when the night comes, they stay at some place, maybe under a tree or wherever they get shelter, they stay at that place for that time being. Again, next morning they start roaming, singing. Okay? With lutes in our hands, ever singing we roam. Always what they have in their hands? They have this musical instrument which is known as lute. All men are our kindred. The world is our home. Now, they are saying all men. All here men means you can say men, women, children, everyone. They are our family. Everyone is our family. The world is our home. They are referring the world as their home. Okay children, these four lines I explained to you today, where the voice of the wind calls our wandering feet through echoing forest and echoing street. With lute in our hands, ever singing we roam. All men are our kindred, the world is our home. You please go through these four lines children. Okay, just read this poem and try to understand whatever I taught you in my class. Thank you.